Alongside Night is one of those terrible movies that it's not so bad it's good, it's so bad it's painful to watch. So it's not like The Room.
What a story, Mark.
Or Birdemic. But more along the lines of Garbage Pail Kids, only if Garbage Pail Kids was directed by an even less competent director. From what I've been told, the book Alongside Night is actually a fairly good novel. However, the author took it upon himself to make a shitty movie out of it.
So, if you buy our drugs, please don't do that.
Which I guess I don't understand. Now, there has been some fairly mixed reviews with this movie, some of which...
I thought it was a great movie. It has a very important message in today's world. It doesn't have a lot of relevant libertarian films, but it was very subtle.
Subtle. And others have referred to it as dog shit, which the author didn't take kindly to. So the movie starts off in the near future. Actually, I don't know, because it doesn't fucking say. The only thing it does do is just drop in on this random shot of two people having an awkward dialogue where they mention some pop culture reference and then start racing up the stairs for absolutely no apparent reason. And by the way, did that scooter have an alarm? Oh my god. So he gets into class and he meets up with a fellow student who gives him, I guess sells him, I don't know what that is, Moon is a Harsh Mistress 3D, the Silk Road Edition. Now, I have some questions. Why is there an official-looking ticket for a Silk Road Edition movie? And why is Penn and Teller on the ticket? Which one plays Manny? Next, we're treated to our next character, which is obviously going to be our love interest, who is sitting there scanning pictures of Federal Reserve notes with her phone and then promptly burning those Federal Reserve notes in class. Now, as dumb and as lazy as government is, I sincerely doubt there would ever be a time or any kind of future where a government would institute a form of currency that would result in burning down a fucking school. Why not just make it digital to begin with? I mean, back when this book was written, that's what all the libertarians were afraid of back in those days, was a cashless society. Oh, that everything has a paper trail. Oh my God. Hold on a moment. I have to buy some shiny badges with these bitcoins I mined with my Raspberry Pi. But that burning effect was some serious CGI movie magic, if you ask me.
No, you do not, Miss Danforth.
Please burn your money on your own time, not mine.
Yes, Dr. Conkin.
Wait a minute. Was his name Dr. Conkin? Conkin, like the agorism guy? Hold on a second. Moon is a Harsh Mistress. Penn and Teller. Silk Road. And Conkin. Okay, so he's trying to gain some libertarian brownie points with this movie by making little tiny references to as many libertarian things as possible. So we're going to start a counter. Now, I know I'm going to miss a few of these here and there because some of these things are probably going to be too obscure for me, even me to know, but I'm going to try my best. So we're going to keep this little counter here at the bottom, and every time he tries to suck some libertarian dick, we're going to give him a point. And look, I am a libertarian. But my problem is this blatant pandering that actually it becomes distracting later on in the movie. You'll see why. So the plot so far is that Dr. Conkin, the principal of Esonia Preparatory School, is replacing the anarcho-communist teacher who has instructed them to make a video promoting mutualism or something because she got a government gig and is no longer teaching the class. But isn't that a private school? Or maybe it's a private school, but why would there be private schools teaching about socialism? And if his dad, which they talk about later, is author of libertarian books and a libertarian economist, why would he send his son to a school that teaches socialism? Get used to this, by the way, because there's lots of things that don't make any fucking sense in this movie.
Fourth.
Mrs. Tobias assigned us a one-minute topic. It's due today.
What topic?
The self-destruction of capitalism.
Well, that sounds fair and balanced.
Doesn't count.
The president said he's trying to save the capitalist system. Mrs. Tobias says the capitalist system can't be saved, and that progressive mutualism is a better system anyway.
Yeah, this principal really has his shit together, doesn't he? By the way, who elected Jake Busey president in this world? I mean, was it because he was a war hero from the bug war?
I need squad leader.
Oh, no. No, I've been there and blew it. I'm just here to fight.
Oh.
Anyways, the kids upload their videos, except for our protagonist, Elliot, who uses this as an opportunity to say that he did something else besides the assigned homework because he didn't like the assigned homework. Damn libertarians and their civil disobedience.
Economics in 1 minute by Elliot Vreeland. Based on the book Not Worth the Continental by Dr. Martin Vreeland.
I guess that counts, but what's with that book cover?
Simple equation, too much aggregation, ignores human action and motivation.
Subtle.
With all due respect to Friedrich Hayek, I think Mick Jagger said it even better. Can't get no satisfaction.
He does a 1 minute economics lesson where he pimps his dad's book, Not Worth the Continental. But only after playing a short clip from the Keynes and Hayek rap battle. Why this clip is in here, it baffles me. I mean, I can understand if it was playing a clip that was relevant to the point that he was going to make in the thing, but he doesn't. In fact, that clip, in its context, doesn't mean anything. I mean, I understand what he's talking about, given I understand a little bit of it about economics, and the fact that I understand where that thing came from, and I was a big fan of the music video, but for anyone who just walks into that movie and has never seen it before or understand any of this stuff, they're going to be fucking in the dark. And by the way, that's going to be the tone with everything in here. There seems to be a lot of context taken out of every single thing that he talks about. And so unless you understand libertarianism, and unless you understand economics of libertarianism, and unless you understand the culture and the memes that come with libertarianism, you're going to be in the fucking dark with this thing. But listen to this.
With all due respect to Friedrich Hayek.
On one hand, by the revolutionary agorist cadre.
Too much aggregation ignores human action and motivation.
And if you didn't pick up on that, it's kind of simple. Everything that the president is saying and everything that Elliot is saying on the television sounds terrible. And it's kind of makes sense because, you know, they're playing it from the TV. But then why does the rap battle sound so good and the laugh track sound so good? Why not make it tinny, you stupid fuck? So anyways, it starts to make a little bit more sense after that, after he gets into a brief topical explanation of marginal utility and exchange, and then bashed a few economists like Adam Smith, Karl Marx, and John Maynard Keynes for reasons.
Then John Maynard Keynes got into the...
What was that?
John Maynard Keynes got into the...
Why did Gilligan pop in and cut off the audio? Never mind. I have a feeling that if I'm going to go into every single editing problem with this video, this is going to be longer than the film, so I'm just going to stick to the major problems.
And the more your government tightens its grip, the more its system will slip through your fingers.
I recognized your foul stench when I was brought on board.
No, more kind of British.
Thank you.
Also, look, this is what his response was after playing that garbage.
Good job, Elliot. I've read your father's book, and you managed to boil down his complex theories into a lucid series of pop culture references. Well done.
And this is what he should have said. I would give you an F for not doing the assignment as assigned, for making a 2 minute long video when you were only supposed to make a 1 minute long video, not making any fucking sense, but you did make the TV sound mighty great. Ever thought of going into sound engineering? Anyways, he dismisses the class's assignment without having watched any more of the videos. And then goes and plays more of the president's talk because, you know, he was saying something along the lines of it's pointless for you to go to school because the economy is so bad. And then plays the president's speech in order to explain why that is. Except the president's speech had nothing to do with that. The video is then interrupted by some guy in his office to tell Mr. Elliot to come down to the office because reasons. And then when he gets there, he doesn't inform that his dad is dead. No, he just says that you need to go with the system. Wait, what the fuck is that on his wall? Is that really a painting of the creation of Adam with the tagline, pull my finger under it? What fucking kind of school is this?
You must leave with your sister.
What happened?
Daddy's dead.
Wait, your dad is Kevin Sorbo? How did you rope this guy into this?
This isn't my world. Disappointed!
Anyways, after he finds out that his dad is dead, he goes into this little montage where he remembers all the good things him and his dad did together, which is just him riding a zip line for 20 feet and shooting some guns. Anyways, the kids grab their stuff from the classroom and then head out, and then we are treated to possibly one of the worst introduction animations I have ever seen. Oh my god. It even has an advertisement for a gold company. Oh, and by the way, no, that's not the Cranberries. What the fuck am I watching? As you can tell, I took about the same amount of time the intro part of this film made talking about all the problems in it. And I'm not going to be doing that for the later portions of the film. I'm going to be talking about some of the more major problems. But I just really wanted to illustrate, just in the very first 10 minutes of this film, how dense the problem areas are in this movie. And this continues out through the entire portion of the film. I'm not going to be doing that as much, but I just really wanted to emphasize how shitty this fucking movie is. So stay tuned for part two. It should be coming out shortly. Worms.